This video is a little different today. It comes from a question that was asked on a forum. If you jumped here from my blog at bluebeamandburgers.com, you'll know a little bit of the background. But in past videos, I showed how to calibrate a drawing with different XY coordinates, and then how we can get the cubic yard measurement for the cut and fill. And this one, the question in the forum was, how would we do that in a plan view? So what I did here was I just came into a plan. I boxed off an area so that we can do these measurements. And today I'm gonna use the dynamic fill tool, which is also another video of mine. I'll put the link up in the upper right. And we're gonna use dynamic fill to get a volume measurement. So if I come over here, and before I do that, I want to show you guys, I just quickly jumped in and built some tools here indicating different depths of cut and fill. So essentially, if we cut through here, this hillside, if we cut it straight down at this line, this one's going to be five feet deep, 4 feet deep, 3, 2, 1, and so on. So I built those tools out over here, and we're going to go ahead and place those markups in here. So I'm going to go ahead and select from here. I can select the tools that are in my tool chest in the pull down. So I'm going to go ahead and select, I'm going to do fill on this one with a 1 foot fill, and grab my paint bucket here. And then all I need to do is come out here and fill this space. Just let the paint fill that area. Hold down my left mouse button. When it's done, I can say apply. Okay, and I'm gonna go on and do the next one, the 2 foot fill. Fill that out. You guys get the idea here. Oops. Leaked over, so I'm going to come up here and clear fill and start it again. Got to be careful not to hit those lines. That's why I just like to hold it in place and let the paint pour where it's going to. Hit apply and so on. So you guys get the idea. And then what we've done is we've kind of filled this out, mapped it out, what it's going to look like. I went ahead and did that down here with the cut tools as well. And now what we can do is look at our markups list, which is going to show all of those quantities. So by subject, you're going to see which of those, that's the 5 foot deep cut. We're going to see the quantities over here as well. And what I did was I went ahead and put cut and fill in the labels as well. So if I sort it by that list, we'll end up with total quantities of all of them that fall under the cut label and all of them that fall under fill. So you can see those total quantities of your cut and fill. Let me know what you think about this workflow. Again, I was just thinking off the top of my head to answer a question in a forum. I'd be interested to see what you think. Thanks for checking out Bluebeam and Burgers. We'll see you on the next one.